you're choosing my story. All right, let's work together then. I finally made it to the city. I hope Ram and Ram are doing all right.
Oh, hello, young lady. Where have you come from?
Young lady? I'm not a young lady. I'm Louise CPU, and...
A CPU? Oh, these youngsters say such funny things these days.
I figured as much. They didn't believe me in the last city either. No one seems to remember me, or any of the other CPUs for that matter. What the hell is going on?
If you're lost, I can show you around. I'm a receptionist at the Guild, so you can rest assured in my knowledge of this city.
The Guild, huh? Well, great timing at least. I did want to stop over by the Guild.
Oh, really? Do you have a request? I'm searching for my younger sisters. Their names are Ram and Ram. They look like... Oh, Ram and Ram! Sure, I know them!
You know about them? Where are they right now?
Those two girls said they would head to Louise capital city to meet their big sister. I couldn't even stop them. Now that I remember, they kept insisting they were CPU candidates as well.
When did this happen?
Just a few hours ago.
Thanks for the info. I'll be going now. I really need to find those two.
Okay, just use the main road, all right? Avoid the woods if you can help it. You'll hear there's a shortcut if you go through there, but lately I've heard there are strange monsters roaming about.
Okay, I'll remember that. What a chore. I should get to the next city past this main road. I hope I can meet up with Ram and Ram there, but... I've never seen this kind of monster before. Is this one of those weird monsters that lady was talking about? Either way, if it's gonna stand in my way like this, I have no choice but to fight it. Your life's gonna be over in 15 turns. Is that it?
Beep, beep. Beep.
Not bad. That one.
I'll crush you.
I'll sneak. Thanks everyone for all your help. They were formidable opponents. I've never seen this species, so maybe I should investigate a little just in case I find one again.
Wait! It's not over!
What? Oh, shoot! I can't... not here...
Whoa! Hey! Hey! Phew, she's just passed out. Okay, that's good. She seems pretty tough. Still... why is a little kid way off the beaten path in a place like this? Oh well, I guess I'll help her out. You're in the way, you know. I'm gonna have you disappear now. Finally awake. Man, you were really knocked out there.
Where...
We're in a hotel, not too far from where you passed out. My name's Sisha.
I'm Blon.
Nice to meet you, Blon. I carried you here, so you can go ahead and thank me now.
Yes, thank you. Hmm? Well, you're...
Hmm? Is there something on my face?
Why are you here?
Whoa, what's with that change in attitude? I'm not sure how to respond to that. Do you know me or something? I'm bad at remembering people's faces. Sorry.
Who are you? What? There's no way in hell you forgot. We just fought each other.
I fought with you? No way. I don't believe it. I would have remembered something like that.
What? Do you remember these freaking fists digging into your cheeks? Just stay right there. Oh.
Hey now, don't push yourself. What'll you do if your wounds reopen?
What's your angle here? Attacking me, then saving me? I don't get you at all.
Sorry, but I really don't remember. This is the first time we've met.
Stop lying to me, damn it!
I'm not, I swear. Besides, if I really attacked you before, why would I save you now? It doesn't make sense, right? You probably just fought someone who looked like me.
Hmm.
If you understand, then lay down and rest. Don't worry, I won't attack or eat you.
I don't know why you'd mention eating me, and frankly, it bothers me. But maybe you're not lying.
Oh good, you're acting like a normal person now. You know, you have a pretty funny personality.
Shut up! Don't think we're friends all of a sudden. I still have no reason to trust you.
Well, all I can do is ask you to trust me because I really don't remember fighting you at all.
Fine. I'll at least believe that you don't remember me. And thanks for saving me.
You're welcome, Blon. So tell me, why were you alone in a dangerous place like that?
That doesn't concern you.
Oh, but it does. If you were fighting monsters, I need to check whether or not you're a hunter.
A hunter? What?
Oh, you don't know? Right. You're not originally from Louis, are you?
No. I am from Louis, born and raised.
Then you must know about the license system, separation of living spaces and all that.
Licenses? Separation of living spaces? I don't remember making those things.
You don't know, even though you're from Louis? Have you been living abroad for a while? I don't understand how you're not aware.
Okay, well, let's just put those questions aside for now. Could you explain all this stuff to me?
The license system is simple. All residents are meticulously managed, all the way down to what professions they hold.
What? The people don't even get to choose what kind of jobs they have?
Right. It's even pretty ordinary for your job to be decided at birth.
That's just ridiculous.
I think that every once in a while, too. The only saving grace is that anyone is free to choose their own side job. Although it's a different matter entirely if you can get the license to hold it.
Is that so? Then, that hunter thing you were talking about is a licensed profession?
Definitely. As a hunter, my job is to exterminate monsters and to complete guild quests.
I see.
Well, that's enough license talk. Just know that if you're going to live here, you need a license or you won't be able to live properly. Where you get to live changes depending on your license and your contributions to the nation, too.
Ah. Is that the separation of living spaces?
Right. I'm able to live a pretty good life, but the gap between rich and poor is visibly terrible. We're in an authoritative society now. It's up to the nation whether you live or die, even. This place only resembles the old Louis in its name.
You've gotta be kidding me! Who's the asshat overseeing something so incredibly outrageous? Louis was never that kind of nation. It's a relaxed, magical, fairy tale kind of land. This overexertion of power never existed. Oh, my Louis. The Louis that I love and vowed to protect isn't that kind of nation.
Wow, your patriotism's kind of surprising. You must really care about Louis, huh?
Of course I care! This is my...
Hey, you're injured still. Don't get too riled up. And to let you know, nobody knows who's really in control here. I'd like to know, too.
If I find that bastard, I'm gonna beat that idiot into a bloody pulp!
Sounds good to me.
But first, I need to find my little sisters.
Oh, you have younger sisters? Did you get separated?
Basically. You're a hunter, right? Do the names Rom or Ram sound familiar?
Nope, I've never heard of them. If they're lost, you can send out a quest and I can begin searching for them.
I'll search myself. That's why I came all the way out here anyway.
How are you going to search? If you don't have a license, you can't move around freely in the Wii.
Then I'll just get one.
Anybody can take the aptitude test, so it'd be good for you to apply. It's not certain that you can become a hunter just by taking a test, though. Don't cry if you can't become one, Blonnie. Oh, come on. It's fine to call you Blonnie, isn't it? Oh, that's right. If you really want to look for your sisters out there, I could let you borrow this room.
What? What's your objective in that?
You're going to suspect a person's goodwill like that? It's not like I'm thinking of having you help me if you become a hunter. I've reached an age where I want to start taking it easy. Having a partner is going to make a lot of things easier. It looked like you could fight monsters all right, so it'd be way better to partner with someone who I know can pull their own weight.
I'll think about it.
Thanks, Blonnie. Well then, I'm going to sleep. If anything happens, please wake me up. Here are the blankets I got from the front desk.
Where are you gonna sleep?
On the floor?
I figured that was your move. Did you only get one room? Or are you just trying to keep an eye on me?
It can't be helped. I could only afford one room with my current income. On top of that, all the other rooms are full, so we're kind of stuck with this for now.
If that's the reason, then I guess it's no use. I'm tired too, so I guess I'll go to sleep now.
You're not gonna ask me if I want to share the bed with you?
I wouldn't want that. I have no idea what you try to pull. Good night. If she really doesn't remember me, then it's probably best to keep quiet about me being a CPU. I'm fine.
Take the aptitude test here. I hope you'll do your best.
That's the plan. Didn't need you to tell me that.
We'll begin the aptitude test momentarily. Please be aware that it will take some time.
That's fine. Let's get started already.
Okay, then let's begin. Please come over to this room.
I'll come pick you up when it's almost over. I'll be crossing my fingers for you to get a hunter's license, Blonnie.
Crossing your fingers is pointless. And stop calling me that already!
If you're able to get a hunter's license, I'll stop calling you Blonnie.
I swear I'll become a hunter.
That's the spirit. Well, qualifying is basically all chance, so good luck.
Ugh. You don't just say that to someone who's about to go take the test.
Well, I've got some time to kill. Hey, you've been spying on me all morning. Is there something you want to talk about?
Ha. You caught me. As expected of you, Seisha.
I don't know you, and I don't remember giving you permission to act so friendly with me.
My name is Asnaleb. I'm but a normal, upstanding citizen.
A self-proclaimed upstanding citizen? Yeah, you're not suspicious at all.
Say what you will of me. Incidentally, I wish to request you for a job. I need a person eliminated.
Why would I accept such a ludicrous request?
I know where the delusionary monsters come from.
Fine. I accept.
Good. The target is the person in this picture.
What? That target is Blonnie.
I was quite surprised when I saw you walking next to her. But it actually is quite convenient.
Why do you need her eliminated?
It's none of your concern. I'll be waiting for a good report.
To think, Blonnie is the target. Oh well, I've no intention of actually doing this job, so I'll make something up to tell him. I think enough time's passed. Blonnie should be done by now. Welcome back, Blonnie. How'd it go?
I qualified as a hunter, no thanks to you. So you can stop calling me that now.
You really became a hunter! Blonnie, that's amazing.
Are you even listening to me?
Now then, Blonnie, let's hurry and go grab a quest.
Can you really not hear me telling you to stop calling me that?
Oh, this is my license card. When you exchange information like this, you can see the other person's status and stuff like that.
Freaking listen to me! Don't tell me you've already forgotten the promise you made before the test!
Ooh, how scary. But don't sweat the small things like that. Come on, let's just accept a random quest. Oh, that's right. I'll go along with you for quests, so you don't have to worry.
Don't just continue the conversation! And damn it, listen to me!
We'll be right back.
You're worried about me? Thanks. Looks like you've decided. Choice, I guess. Going in.
Thank you.
our chance to round them all up. There! I'll end this! That was an attack. I got hit? My turn. Just a what a wimp. I'll crush you. Yeah. I'll smash you. Ow. Doesn't work. I'll take credit for that one. I can't believe I got pushed so far! Could you heal me soon? Jump! Tup! Jump! Jump! What's this? Jump!
of Louise CPU!
What a chore. Maybe I'll read a bit. Really? Well... Annoying.
You wanna be starting something? You wanna be starting something?
How bad? Ow! Cool. Doesn't work! I've got a little present for ya! I need to heal. Weak. I can't believe I got pushed so far. Really? Well, it's your choice, I guess. Thank you. Let's do our best. Jump! Jump! An item! What's this? You're worried about me? Thanks! Mm. An item!
They outsmarted us!
My turn! I'll crush you! My turn!
I'll take credit for that!
Up with them afterwards, Blonnie. I get how you feel, but these monsters aren't going to wait for us to sort this all out.
Yeah, you're right. I have to thank them for all the bullshit they've been putting my little sisters through.
I'm a CPU candidate of the Wii, too! I have to do my best! I did my best, Ram!
I'll get stronger. Even stronger! That should do it. Jeez, what futile resistance!
It should be safe here now. I'll keep a lookout, so go ahead.
My babies, I'm so glad you're safe. Did you think I was gonna say that, you little idiots? Ah! Don't be so damn reckless. Becoming hunters and then ending up in this situation?
But we thought if we became hunters, we'd be able to get back to where you were.
Even then, don't you know your own limits? If you were unlucky, you two might have...
Sorry for cutting in, but you became a hunter because you wanted to find these two, right? The way I see it, you're not really in a position to be scolding them like that.
Huh? You're a hunter too? I didn't know.
That's true, but...
You were worried about them too, so why not just admit that you're happy to see them?
Lon?
Fine, I got it. Have you two learned your lesson?
Yeah, we have! We won't do dangerous things like that ever again!
All right. I'll forgive you this time.
Yay! Thank you, Blon!
I'm glad you two are all right. I'm really, really glad you're both okay.
We're sorry. We just really wanted to find you. We couldn't sit still thinking that you might disappear again.
It's fine. I understand. You're injured. So let's go clean up your wounds.
Okay!
All's well that ends well, it seems.
Lon? Who is this person?
I'll explain while we walk back. It's gonna be a long story.
Sure.
I'm back.
Thank you.
Tasha is Louise Ruler? Then that means she's been deceiving me this whole time. It can't be. Seisha would never make such ridiculous rules. Seisha, I need to talk to you. Could you come with me for a second?
What's the matter?
Just follow me. Rom, Ram, don't come out of this room for a while, okay?
What's wrong, Blonde? You're making your scary face.
Don't worry about it. Just stay here quietly until we come back. Let's go, Seisha.
Blonde? Seisha? What happened?
I don't know, but we should probably stay put. Blonde seemed real serious about it, too.
We don't have to worry about being overheard here, so be frank with me, all right?
Sure.
I heard from a certain someone that you're the current leader of Louis, and that you're part of Gold Third.
Oh, you want to talk to me about this, huh? Yeah, that's right. I'm the Gold Third of Louis, although I'm not exactly a ruler or anything.
So, it was true. Why didn't you tell me before?
I really feel sorry about that, but you're a CPU and I'm part of Gold Third.
You did remember me this whole time.
At first, I was trying to atone for my sins. I don't know why, but because we defeated you and the other CPUs, the world changed. I tried to bring it up so many times, but as I got closer and closer to you, it just got that much harder to come clean about it.
Then, the story about you creating all those delusionary monsters...
You heard about that, too? Where did you even get that information?
From your reaction, I'm assuming it must be true, right?
Yeah, it's true. I was hiding it for my own advantage. Where do I begin? At some point, I started having strange dreams. Or, I guess they were more like nightmares. Ever since I started seeing them, a strange dark red fog would leak from my body.
What? From your body? Are you sick or something?
It's rare for you to worry about me. Thanks, but the fog seems benign. Since I had no idea what it was, I thought it might have some effect on other people. I've been leaving the city to release it. Since I started releasing the fog, it stopped leaking out of me. But that was a bad idea. More monsters started going berserk, and these monsters were directly influenced by the fog.
Those are the delusionary monsters.
Exactly. I became a hunter so I could reduce the number somewhat. I feel like it's solely my responsibility.
You seem pretty half-assed about it, considering.
Well, nobody can stay sharp forever. I think that's about it, though. That's the story. Anything else you want to ask me?
There's one thing that doesn't add up. When was the license system created? Because you most likely started ruling over Louis after you guys defeated us. But, even though it hasn't been that long, the system is so deeply rooted in the culture. It's so normalized with the citizens here.
That's actually something I don't get either. That day when the light subsided, the world truly changed. It was as if Gold Third had always been in power over the nations. The license system was already binding this nation, as if it had been decided from years ago within Louis's government. But there's definitely someone else who created this system. That's why I've been searching for this elusive ruler. To abolish it.
Can't you use your authority to find them and abolish the system?
I can't do that when all I have is this flimsy title. Besides, there's a rumor that Gold Third created the system, so it'd just make it worse.
Seisha.
Now I've told you everything that was hidden. It's your turn now, Blani. Where did you get this information from? This contact of yours knows way more than they should.
The person who gave me this information is...
There's no need to tell her.
What are these people?
Seisha, we will restrain you.
What's the meaning of this?
Well done, Lady Blonde. We are the Revolutionary Army. Our master is waiting.
What's going on here?
We took the liberty of recording your entire conversation. We were able to record solid evidence of Seisha being the source of Louise's chaos.
Why?
This is all thanks to you, Lady Blonde. Our master will surely reward you quite generously.
Blonnie, you sold me out? All for a reward?
No, I didn't know about this either.
Then why are members of the Revolutionary Army calling you Lady?
Seisha, it's a misunderstanding. You guys better let go of Seisha right now.
We cannot do that. Take her away.
Blonnie, I seriously thought you were a good partner.
Seisha! Let me go!
I cannot. That woman is dangerous.
Just let me go, you bastard!
Please, calm down, Lady Blonde.
Asnaleb, you worthless scum! How dare you lie to me!
Lie to you? Whatever do you mean? I only requested you investigate her. Isn't it you who expertly performed that task, Lady Blonde?
Bastard! You tricked me! I'll smash your face in!
Can you do such a thing? Are you able to hurt the soldiers who protect me? Your citizens?
Damn it!
Now then, Lady Blonde. Until next we meet.
Seisha, I'm so sorry. I'll save you. Just hold on a little longer.
Thank you.
It's your choice,
annoying.
I guess.
My turn!
It doesn't work! Yeah! Oh, what a wimp! What a chore. Even I can tell this is too much for me. But I can't afford to pull back now. I swear I'll stop them here! Don't think you'll go home easy now that you've seen this form. Pretty good. I can go anytime. Against this mini is gonna be damn tough after all. I just hope Financier's group is doing all right.
I can hear people screaming. How nice. No matter where they run, it's no use. There's no way they'll be saved when even the hunters who are supposed to protect them have all fled. They'll realize who's been helping them all this time. They're fading away, lying in a small pool of their own blood. It's overflowing more and more. More delusionary monsters will be born. I don't care what happens.
Lady Seisha!
His voice. Financier?
Thank goodness you're all right. The guards were gone, so I thought you might have been moved.
Do you have business with me?
I beg of you, Lady Seisha. Please, help Lady Blon.
Help Blonnie? I don't get what you mean.
Lady Blon is currently fighting alone against the horde of monsters approaching the city.
She is? Why is she doing something so useless? She could flee and save her life if she wants.
Lady Seisha?
I won't help. Why do I have to fight in order to protect this city's inhabitants?
What's wrong, Lady Seisha? To say such a thing?
I have no intention of fighting for the people of this city. Everyone can fall prey to the monsters for all I care. It'll serve them right. All those idiots who don't understand just who fought for them, protected each one of them.
Why were you fighting? Until now, Lady Seisha. Weren't you fighting because you loved this beautiful nation of Louis? If you love Louis, then that must mean you love her cities and all of her people there.
It's true that I did love Louis, but no matter how much I did, I...
Have you properly conveyed your love? If you don't properly voice your feelings, how can other people understand? I think it's fine if your feelings of fighting for someone only goes one way. Even if it's a one-sided display at first, one day, they'll come to understand you soon. I truly believe it.
Do you think they'll really understand?
Yes, I'm sure.
If I apologize, will everyone forgive me?
If you properly apologize, they'll forgive you. I know it. This is Louis, after all. It's a magical fairy tale nation, a wonderful and relaxed place.
Yeah, you're right. Blania said the same thing before. What was I even troubled over? Her love for this nation is so much greater than mine. I can't even compare. Yet, even though she was put on a wanted list and chased by the citizens, she still risks her life and fights for them. All I did was end up hating and cursing the citizens over something so small. I really am an idiot, aren't I?
Lady Sisha, will you help us?
Of course. I won't let anyone destroy this city that I love.
Jackasses just keep on coming. But I have my own will to live. I won't let you do as you please. Not bad. My turn. My turn. My turn. My turn. I can go anytime. Come on. I can go anytime. Who wants to get defeated? I can go anytime. I'll be the one to end this. My turn. I'll be the one to end this. Who wants to get defeated? I was confident in my defense, but... I'll be the one to end this.
Curse you!
Not bad. Oh. Get defeated! My turn! I'll be the one to end this! Disappear that! Who wants to get defeated? I'll be the one to end this! I was confident in my defense, but... I'll be the one to end this! I can go anytime! My turn! I can go anytime! Ha! Can't believe I let my guard down! I've gotten even stronger! Damn it! What numbers?
Now you just sound pathetic.
His voice!
Hey there, Blani.
Sisha? Didn't you get caught?
Financier came to save me. Well, I'll tell you about all that later. Right now, we need to get this mess sorted out.
Huh. Talking so smart even though you just got here. Weren't you in a cell, though? Can you just jump in so soon?
Who do you think I am? I'm the hunter... No. I'm one of the Gold Third, Sisha.
We'll be right back.
have a fair fight.
That was an attack?
Enemy sighted.
Not bad. Yeah, I messed up. This.
Okay, are you ready?
I'll remove the Maverick. Who wants to get defeated? What you? This'll end it!
Enemy acquired.
It's scratched.
Enemy acquired.
Not bad.
Let's party. Jeez, what an annoyance. Eat this! Jackpot! Let's head home and eat dinner. I feel like I could eat 10 servings of everything right now.
Damn it. How many has it been now?
I stopped counting about halfway.
I can keep going! I want to say that at least, but I can't. My body's heavy.
Looks like it's the end here. Thanks for everything, Blonnie. It's been real fun.
What are you giving up for? We bought time, now we can escape!
You say that even though you had no intention of running away from the start. I knew from the start that, as a CPU, you'd never seriously use a strategy that would abandon a city.
Of course. There's no way I'm gonna let any more of my cities be destroyed.
I feel the same way. Let's show them the inner strength of the Golden Pair.
Don't use that stupid freaking name! Wait, what's this noise?
Huh? You're right. What is it? Footsteps?
Go! Everyone, charge! What the hell's that?
Hunters from the guild. Didn't they run away?
Lon, Sisha, are you all right? We came to save you guys.
Ram? And Rom too?
Lon! You're really hurt. I'll heal you right now.
Wait, before you do that, what's going on?
Oh, you two were all right. I'm so glad.
Financier, you're here too?
Me and Rom and Financier and the woman from the guild brought back all of the hunters.
They told us that the Golden Pair was taking on the horde of monsters.
We couldn't flee like pathetic wimps when two girls were out here still fighting a good fight. Whoa, we'll let you thank us later. Right now, we have to clean this up.
Come on, you guys. Don't let any of those monsters out alive. They can't mess with our city.
Yeah!
Huh. What do you think, Lady Sisha? The people of this nation are really something, aren't they?
Yeah, you're totally right. I'm embarrassed myself that I ever hated them.
I'm relieved to hear you say that.
Sisha!
Lonnie, I was late in telling you this, but I'm sorry for keeping quiet about things.
You don't have to apologize. You weren't trying to trick me, right? Besides, I should apologize for letting Asnaleb trick me. I'm real sorry.
You don't have to apologize either. Everything is Asnaleb's fault.
Thanks. It helps to hear you actually say that.
Let's be friends again, Blonnie.
Yeah, you bet.
It looks like you two have made up. Friendship is a beautiful thing.
Yeah, it'd be a waste for the golden pair to break up.
Okay, I know we're friends now, and that's nice. But can you change that stupid-ass name already?
Oh, geez, here we go. It's fine, isn't it? Whatever, let's go. The golden pair has one more difficult job to do. Lifted on hunting. Sometimes the most important battle is the battle within.
Really? Well, let's hear.
It looks like the city hasn't been damaged. Thank goodness.
We all work together to protect it, so I guess it makes sense.
Oh? Why, if it isn't the prisoner and the wanted criminal over there?
Asnaleb, Where have you been hiding?
Where?
Why are you acting like that? You were the very first one to run away.
I do not know what you're implying. Besides, who would believe words from a prisoner?
This jerk.
Now, hunters, capture these criminals. Well? Why won't anyone capture them? They're the ones responsible for tarnishing Louise's fine name.
That's not true. At the least, Lady Blonde and the others love this city more than you, coward.
What are you saying, financier? There's no existing evidence that I ran away.
I'll testify to that then.
What? You?
Asnolep said it didn't matter if this was destroyed or if the people left or not, as long as he was safe. What?
No way! He ran away and left us all here to fend for ourselves? What kind of man is that?
It's nonsense. This man is an associate of those criminals.
He's the one who arranged for Blonde to be placed on the wanted list.
You scum!
Sir Asnalep tried to execute Lady Blonde and Lady Seisha, all for his own greed. Those two were innocent.
Silence! Who do you think I am?
The god who created the license system.
What?
You must have a pretty deep connection with the nation if you knew that I was the ruler of Louis. Putting aside whether you created the system or not, there's a high chance you know who did.
You must be joking!
Now, why don't you let us hear your side of the story, Mr. Asnalab?
There are things we'd like to ask you. We'll have you come along. Quietly.
This is ridiculous! Let go of me! You ordinary weak people can't do anything without my guidance or management! You need to let yourself be controlled by me! For the sake of your happiness! What's so good about Louis being ruled by a girl who looks middle-aged? Oh, the horror!
Don't give me that shit!
You hit me! Even my own father never hit me! How dare you punch my face! With a fist, even!
Yeah, I punched you! So freaking what? And the citizens of Louis aren't weak. They don't need your damned oversight.
You heard the lady. We don't need you, so get to walking already.
You look really refreshed. I feel pretty good after seeing all that. I guess it's my turn next. Watch me, Blonnie.
Seisha?
Hey! Are you all listening? My name is Seisha, and I'm the Gold Third, ruling over Louis. Because I was a coward, I let that idiot have his way with Louis. And I sincerely apologize.
This isn't your fault! You aren't responsible for Asnalab's own stupidity!
Even still, I'm at fault. I'm the leader, yet I neglected my duty and became a hunter, wandering around the nation. If I had been more responsible, this never would have happened. So, I have a favor to ask all of you. I ask that you will accept me as your leader.
What? Accept you?
You were Louise Gold Third?
I know that she rarely shows herself, but I never expected the leader to look like some kid.
I know that I'm not very reliable, but I love Louis. So please, let me protect the nation I love. I guess they won't accept me after all. Of course it wouldn't be so convenient.
I think it sounds all right with me.
I'm fine with it too. Anyone who boldly loves Louis is a good person in my book.
You risked your life to protect this city. I can leave this nation to someone like you.
Is it really okay?
They're saying it's fine, so it's fine, isn't it?
Financier!
What are you doing? They're all right with leaving things to you, so you have something to say, right?
Right. I may be a little unreliable, and I can get lazy at times. But I'll do my best for Louis. So let's all make this place into a wonderful nation.
Is this okay, Blonde?
It's fine for now. I don't want to destroy this piece by trying to force them to remember. Louis has to make some changes for it to rise above this dystopia it's been in for a while. It's best to let Sisha run things right now.
What are you doing over there, Blonnie? Come over here!
Hey, don't pull me like that! You're the star here, not me!
You and I are both stars. Hey, so, I was thinking about having you be a secretary at the Basilicom.
Are you just deciding my job without permission? I thought we were over that. I'm not doing it.
Oh, come on. We're a pair. We're in this together.
That's separate from what you're talking about.
It's better for someone who understands the situation to do it. Besides, this is an order from the omnipotent Gold Third.
Hey, don't start talking like that, you jackass. That's freaking low and dirty.
Lady Blonde and Lady Sisha really get along.
Don't joke with me, Sisha. Let me go!
It's quite the happily ever after.
Yep! Uh-huh. It ain't happy at all!
Just like Blonde said, nothing's happy at all. This is just the beginning, in reality. Now, Sisha, it's time to awaken as a vessel.
Sisha, what's wrong?
That's right. I had completely forgotten about this. Guess it won't let things end peacefully.
You suppress the delusionary power too much. To think your actions to protect this nation's people would backfire like this.
I don't know who you are. Are you the mastermind?
All you need to know is that I'm taking control of your body. I'm looking forward to what this golden power of yours is like.
So that's your objective? There are things I need to do. I won't let you. Sorry, Blonnie, but I have business that I need to take care of. Can you wait for me a little bit?
Huh? Sisha? Where are you going? Sisha! This adventuring brings. I'm back! Now I can rest. What should I write for my next novel? Maybe I should just write some trendy stuff. What's this? Let's do our best.
Ha! Jump! Jump!
Lonnie, sorry to make you worry.
If you really cared, you wouldn't have run off without saying anything.
Huh, yeah. All right, good point. I destroyed the crystal in this tower that's the source of my strength in order to prevent this, but I'm in a sorry state.
This tower is the source of Gold Third's strength?
I should have sealed my power. But it's overflowing from deep within me, and it can't be suppressed. It's going to overtake me.
You can't give up! We'll save you!
Leave healing to me.
I'm grateful, but this isn't something that can be fixed by healing. It's too late for me. Even now, I just want to fight against Blani so badly. It's unbearable. Taking all I have to suppress this urge. So please, Blani, while I'm still holding myself back.
Why do you resist? You should just fall quickly and hand your body over to me already.
Seisha!
Ah!
Well, I guess we're really doing this.
I don't want to, but it's what she wanted. I have to defeat her here, before she hurts the people of Louis. But you two don't have to push yourselves. I'll handle this myself.
No, I'll fight too.
Yeah, me too!
I don't know how, but there might be some way we can save Xisha. We have to try.
I agree with Bram. I won't give up. Lon, you can't give up either. Let's try our hardest to save her.
Lon, Bram, right. We won't fight to defeat her, but to save her.
Yeah!
You hear that, Xisha? I don't know how, but I'm going to save you!
Oh, you dare challenge me? No matter. It's always fun to kill a god. You will feel the pain of my surge of delusion!
I don't know what you're talking about, but I'm gonna bear the burden of all your darkness!
Nothing can stand up to my fist! Did you believe you would have better odds if you faced me as a group?
It's okay to heal, right? I'll heal you.
My turn!
Ah!
Feed it to me!
So cornered. Still, you have good fists. This is truly a battle to the death.
This still isn't enough? Damn it! How long are you gonna be like this, Seesha? There are lots of people in Louis who are worried and waiting for you to return.
That's right! Let's play games together again! I want to play with you again, Seesha!
I am delusion itself. Strife is stronger than words. Now, let's fight until either perishes.
I don't want to fight. Let's pull pranks on Blonde like we did before. Let's doodle again, okay?
Hmm? Wait, doodling?
We all doodled on Blonde's novel script together, Seesha. Don't you remember?
Hey, wait! So you snots really were the ones responsible for that!
Whoops!
And you, Seesha! How dare you act all innocent!
Wait, Blonde! We need to persuade Seesha to come back to our side first!
Shut up! That doesn't matter anymore! That was going to be my masterpiece! And thanks to you bastards, my work was ruined!
But we didn't have any paper to doodle on. You always tell us to conserve resources.
Don't mess with me! I won't forgive you!
Run away! Wait, Ram!
Stop running! Get back here!
What is this? Horsing around during battle?
Ha! I was waiting for that opening. Grit your teeth, Seesha!
Ah! Did you really have to hit me straight in the face? With a fist.
Seesha, you all right?
Is that something you'd ask a person you punched?
I had no choice. I was trying to bring you back.
Seesha! Seesha!
Rom, Ram, and you too, Blonnie. I'm so sorry for worrying all of you.
Why didn't you just ask for help?
It'd be wrong of me to burden you, so I thought it'd be fine if I endured it, but I never expected this to happen.
I had no intention of dissolving our pair.
If you think of me as your partner, then I'd like you to confide in me. If you release your delusion powers, and it creates delusionary monsters, all we need to do is defeat them.
That's right! We just have to beat them all up! Isn't that right, Rom?
Right, Ram.
Thank you, everyone.
Let's head home to our Louis.
Okay.
So, Seesha couldn't become a vessel. Oh well, it looks like they managed to obtain the target item anyway.
So, Steamax, did you obtain the item that was enshrined within Louis?
As your information stated, it was stored in the mansion's basement of the revolution leader, so it was simple to steal. But what exactly is this controller? Upon inspection, it seems like an old model.
You wish to know?
Yes, I do.
No can do.
Oh, General, please don't tease me! I've been so bothered by what it could mean, I can't sleep at night!
Exaggerating as usual, Z-Max. However, I can't tell you now.
No way!
There's no need to be so depressed. I will tell you when the time comes.
So, you'll tell me when we collect all the parts?
Correct. Once they've all been gathered.
This adventuring brings about some inspiration for my novels.
By the way, Seisha.
What's up, Lonnie?
We're going to have a nice long chat when we get back, so I hope you're ready.
Huh? What about the sentimental ending sequence? Aren't we partners now?
This is a separate issue. The crime of ruining my novel is heavy. Rom, Ram, you're at fault too.
What should we do?
Why don't the three of us run away?
I agree. Run away!
Hey! Don't you run off! Wait up, you jackasses!
Are you kidding? We're out of here.
Run! Run away! If we get caught, we'll be punished.
And so, the four of them led a very peaceful life which suited them so well, and all the citizens of Louis were incredibly happy, forever.
Don't try to end this all nice and sweet. We're not done talking yet. The scene's still going.
Hey, we're at the end. We have to wrap this up nicely for the fans.
Like I freaking care!
Oh, hey, wait. There's still something I haven't told you yet.
Aw, damn it. Don't tell me you're hiding another stupid freaking power or some idiotic nonsense.
No. I just wanted to thank you for coming to find me and for saving me.
Huh? What are you saying so suddenly?
Well, you know, there wasn't really a good time to say it before. Oh, and one more thing. I'm home, Blonnie.
Welcome home, Seisha.